Ah, equals two, okay. Alright, we're going live in. Elfeld versus Soul matchup. It's been
backdash already.
English.
Oh, alright.
Okay, yeah. 5H, nope, you can crouch out of that. Soul pressure, why don't you block? Is this button check?
No.
Can't be.
Oh yeah, the sweet YSC.
Frame traps. Here, plus frames.
Oh, yes.
Hey,
combo.
Hey,
the drop. Elfeld has a weird hitbox though.
Yeah.
Hitbox.
Air hitbox is moved up, transformed upwards.
Yeah.
Like, the Essence Core Potemkin combo does not work on her.
Damn.
Oh. Close S. Good anti-air.
I like the way Candeep is moving in because Ekuzu doesn't seem to be able to handle it right now.
Yeah, Candy really has his number, but he still makes mistakes. Oh, good 6P, but no conversion.
Alright, now in chip range.
Backdash.
Oh, he wanted to chip out of Fafnir. Was that?
Dump on Grand Viper.
Grand Viper the game.
It's not dumb if it works.
Alright.
Ah, 6P to 6H.
A good counter hit.
No
knockdown. That's so important in this matchup.
2D,
Burst. Good burst, but actually doesn't punish, sadly.
EP City. Okay, dead angle.
Okay, safe jump.
Pressure continues. Foul Fage, get out of my face. 5K entire.
And Candeep just throwing out Fafnir Bringers all day long.
He doesn't care. There is the wild throw. Almost. He's making scramble bags.
I don't know what he's going for.
Good
blitz. I feel like blitz should hurt the shotgun pressure quite a bit.
Yes. Yeah. However, you can the shotgun sense has a command grab, so it's still beatable.
Yeah, sure.
Currently I can't see the screen. Okay, now.
All right. Elfeld was in the corner, now no burst anymore.
No instant dash combo. Fafnir, and it works!
The classic! Nice!
Oh,
good stun, that's death. Nice delayed Fafnir to catch her while she's falling down.
Actually, Candeep is a little bit sad because he can't play Kum Hei Yun in the tournament.
Yeah, it's his new main, he wants to drop Soul and Revelator.
Kum Hei Yun is his character. Like, it feels natural for him. Okay, Candeep has now the.
Alright, now shotgun pressure.
Score is already 1-0 for Candeep.
And now.
If someone can update the score.
Ekuzu with the perfect. That's
1-0 for Candeep, thank you.
The classic.
Plus frames. Does not respect it.
Goes for the 5HS EID link.
Bursts out. Battle Express.
Nice air grab.
No conversion.
Get out of
Just out of range.
Nice. That hurts.
I'm talking about conversions.
Damn. Really, really good dust loops. Oh, he went for the reset.
Good burst bait, but no chance to punish. Jump dust. Transformed into 5D. 2S, one of Elfeld's better buttons.
Bridal Express, very nice.
Who am I kidding? Now, she has all the good buttons.
Corner pressure shot. Goes for the command grip immediately.
Hey!
You get a sigh?
She's
dead?
No!
What?
What? Okay.
He might kill her.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
That's sad.
Whoa. That's
so
really
sad.
Brutal.
2-0 for Candeep. The drops are real. Drops are real.
Had he just hit the sniper shot, that would have been it. Damn.
So that was our first prominent stream match because we can't stream all of groups, naturally. So we picked out the best players when they're facing each other in the group. So we bring them on stream. And just like I said, it's one of the two best. One of the two really good players.
This
we
is
going
to be a good one.
We have PRK from Czech Republic.
versus ATG from Germany on Chip.
Chip versus Sato.
Oh my. This is gonna be interesting.
This is really gonna be interesting. However, they faced off in casuals before. This is pool. Let me just check. This is group number one.
Pool one.
Group number one has ATG, Maho Shosho, Shino, Chase Serene, PRK, and MDZ Kicksboy. my prediction for this group is that ATG and PRK will move on swimmingly.
Yeah. PRK's Zato is really scary.
Yeah. His Zato really leveled up.
Yeah, the pressure is unlocked.
From the last time I fought him.
All right, seems like we're going in.
Okay, right. ATG rocking the new colors.
Just some quick settings.
New DLC colors. This could already be a winner's final match.
Oh yeah, for real. These two are so strong. So I'm just guessing this match
here
is
going
to be...
Here we have PRK rocking the poncho.
But no sombrero today.
No sombrero.
That's he weak.
Needs, yeah, he needs all the vision he can get. Okay, we're going in. Chip has the opportunity to hunt Sato really comfortably. And Eddie already bites the dust.
Yeah. Ooh, I think he also has very good tools against
And finally, can you see me? Oh,
okay, nice
out.
Burst.
Eddie is there.
Now some control from full screen.
And Eddie's gone. Oh, he tries to poke him out here. Ooh, nice.
All right,
jump
nice.
Out,
I confirm.
Gets hit anyway. Into the corner.
Oh, nice.
But cannot
Sadly
get a hot knock down.
Oh, the P-Mash.
Okay, will we see some Eddie? No, not yet.
Oh my, this is carnage.
Walker throw. Okie same at low. Come on, grab. Follow up in the corner.
Oh my, this is going to be a tough one to block. Oh.
And yeah, just chipping him out. PRK has not shown a strong offensive yet, but once he gets a bus saw in, yeah, all drill.
Now it's gonna be good.
Oh, Nobby will counter.
Nobby Roo is so
And that
good.
Was one of the best first plates. And that's why he ate the gold first. Here's the blender. Oh, and the super.
Oh, all right,
bust
out.
Smart decision. This mix-up is one of the better things of Chip. And
all right, now the corner
cross-up. Still in the blender, and he goes high.
Ooh, nice.
Alpha Blade. Oh, he's going for damage. And he... Oh,
Ooh,
yeah.
With a super.
Yeah, he had super.
That was pretty good.
I totally forgot that he could use that for damage.
Yeah.
Usually used as a setup. So that's 1-0 for OTG, and we're going back in. Thank you, Revelator, for instant rematch. Makes our life so much more comfortable.
So. I'm hoping that we can see a little bit more of Eddie's pressure.
Does not really hit him
game.
Yet. Okay, low.
Oh, went for the command grab. Ooh. Now drills.
Oh, 6P's in the wrong direction.
Oh no, Nobiru from the puddle.
Yeah, but Chip's teleports really know how to deal with Eddie. Ooh, Shadow All Gallery. Right. Okay, Eddie's out.
Unsaw.
No, Nobiru. Just castration. Him. And low.
Alright guys, I'm sorry I gotta go.
Yeah,
I'm playing a match on stream.
Best of luck. Okay, Shadow Gallery to get it out. Eddie Basso, now the pressure starts. But Chip has a DP. Oh, Datuman Sendu into goal first. This is not looking good for PRK right now. But ADG already used all his meter. Eddie should return soon. Oh no. Oh, good block. Could have been it. Oh, you look! And PRK is on the board. Will this be the comeback? And Sluno. 1-0. Still 1-0. But PRK can now take it back. But ATG working on the chip. Oh, and catches him. The resets. Oh, okay. Interesting. He didn't go for high or low. He just wanted to catch a jump back. And here we have Eddie Pressure. A-A-O-I-I. Oh, it goes for Comic Grab, but HEG reacts in time and picks him out. HEG now with Gates now with Match Pawn. But PRK out of the strong offense. Vilu, Vilu, Vilu. Low, low, low. The question is, when will he bust? There comes the burst. And Eddie has to recover now. Because PRK was looking for an unblockable setup. So Eddie really takes a lot of time. Oh, Wasabi. Oh, clutch, clutch. Oh, burst bait. Alpha blade, alpha blade. Ooh, nice block. Oh, okay, power grab would have worked as well. Oh, that was so close. Chipping out, and 1-1. PRK is still alive. Hey, guys. FFM Rumble starting off just fine. Oh, 6P. But Eddie has already died, so Sato has to get him away. Use a bubble and get Eddie out, just like that. Oh, block low, boy. Oh, tries to put him back in the corner. Which is pretty difficult once Chip is in the air. Nice burst bait by PRK. Obilu, oh, gets beaten by the sweep. But he still has him locked down. He cannot stand up. PRK knows how to set those drills, so you have to block low the entire time the drill is out. If you're standing up, you get hit. Really nice technique from Sato. But AGG now back with a really strong offense. And will he block this? No, he can't. Bad angle out. Nobilu, oh, this could have been it if he just pressed the button. Now, pressure. Can AGG? No, he cannot block this. Yeah, AGG is probably the best EU chip I've seen. We all know him. He already visits the Sacred Shrine, also known as Mikado game. Mikado Takano Noba. Now PRK with the match point, but yeah, but ATG working on the corner pressure. Can this kill? I think so. Yeah. This is still really exciting, guys. Oh, but this conversion will hurt a lot. 50% down the drain. Hey, Jobu. Oh, PRK needs to recover quickly. He has his burst, but he can get baited. Oh, no. Oh, no, he stuck his soul, and that's it. Really nice gameplay by HEG. But I think we will see more of PRK, because I think he really has the... he really has the skill to get off groups. So, next up... It looks like Grammas from Italy is coming up. With his opponent, I am not sure. There are a lot of people there. Grammas in the black outfit with the sunglasses and his cape, his hat. Oh, PRK. I hope he can recover from this shock. He just needs to feel his inner Mexican. So this should be, let me just say what group this is. This is group 5. Group 5 being a little bit small. Only five people there. We have Grammas, Sumpfauge, M. Was scheiße. Was? Ich lese die Gruppen vor. Oder... Sollen wir das nicht? Okay. Alright. Grammas versus Filser, which means we have Soul versus Mate. Filser, player from Munich. Should be interesting. The just checking our equipment to give our players the best sound possible. Take a little quick sip. Plugging in. Yeah, top 16 will be really interesting. Okay, joining me now is
Jesus Christ. Okay. Apparently, I don't get a headphone, but that's okay.
Okay, my name is Jesus. My name is Fortify owner. You can see that.
I got my name backwards because I'm a hipster.
Yeah, hipster. Hipster. Okay, and the match should start soon. Grammas is just selecting his favorite music.
Grammas.
Or he's just sending out some tweets. I don't know what he's doing.
I don't know either, but it's probably something that's totally going to determine
maybe
this match.
Maybe he has notes on May. Or even notes on Filzer.
Maybe, but probably not. So Filzer plays at...
Alright, Grammas looks like he's ready.
That's her name. I almost forgot it. At least usually he does, and Grammas plays Sol. So, what do you think about that matchup?
It's pretty even, actually. May has some really good gimmicks concerning Okiseme. Her neutral is not too bad as well, and her damage is really good. And Sol, well, I think we all know Sol.
Yeah.
To some degree, we all know what Sol is capable of.
The original Gorilla.
Yeah. However, I think he only got gorilla status with Sign, with Exart. Yeah. In Essence Core, he was not that much of a gorilla.
Yeah, probably. I don't really know about the previous Guilty Gears all that much.
Here we have, zoning is already going on. Foozies.
Yep, lots of dolphins.
Let's just go in with 5k. What should happen? What you gonna do?
Not gonna block this. Oh.
Dolphin!
Hopefully, hasn't come for any.
Too much FD, if you ask me. You need the meter.
Yeah. Before he's just
closer,
happily zoning him. Oh, there goes the burst, but it didn't hit, so just nothing in the turn line.
Okay, get him into the gun flame. Burst out, smart decision, that would be a hard combo.
Back to zoning.
Here comes the
Seems
ball.
Like he's happily
drop the ball.
In that position.
Oh, okay. Dolphin, pressure again, sweep, up
no,
down. Oh,
they
didn't
No
the
overheads,
DP.
No nothing. Just wants to keep up the pressure without giving him any time to interrupt.
Both players with approximately same health.
Not anymore.
Now, May with the up down. May has 50%.
Oh.
What is she gonna do with it? That angle, but still safe.
Back to the zoning.
Here comes SeaWorld. Wilson knowing his zoning game.
And he drops
the relaunch.
Combo.
That was crucial.
Yeah, but he gets the overhead.
Just get him overhead.
Pretty solid by Filzer there. Didn't take too many risks, just kind of zoned him out and took the hits where he could.
Yeah. He's keeping a cool head.
Yep. Keeps this up, he's probably gonna take
he's
it, but you know, Graham might just
and
adapt.
Back to the corner. Oh, just no conversion overhead to Kisu.
Does takes him out of the corner, so maybe that's
no
gonna
conversion.
Bite him.
Bad conversion. Now Grammas, will he put in work?
Apparently
now,
he won't.
Now Grammas is on the offensive while
that's
close.
That's where it all starts.
A simple corner.
Corner position. And that
knockdown. No Fafnir. Grammas now with a lot of meter.
Could use it all.
And,
but,
what?
Oh,
oh
whoa,
nice.
That was a pretty fancy
that,
combo.
That looked like a combo drop, but it was actually a combo.
Yeah. And he gets
and
it.
Chip.
Yeah,
that's chips him out. Nice air throw in the corner.
That's actually pretty sad because Filzer had a lot of meter and full burst, but you know. That's another round.
Yeah, both players still have their burst.
Yep.
Or got him back.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, and Senga, and 50% down the drain.
That's May.
Oh, back to catching, but no conversion.
He kind of gave up the zoning game
Blitz, but
after that match, after the first round.
Unfortunately,
oh, near. God, no.
There was no counter, so... Should be safe.
Yeah, but he's still in the corner, but he fights his way out.
Oh, no bait.
Oh,
oh
no.
When in doubt, Fafnir.
Yeah.
But Filzer retaliates. Ooh, tries to overhead kiss.
Yeah, come on, grab him.
Jumpy. Both fiends out. Smart.
Just gotta play it safe now.
Respect them
as safe
pressure.
As you can, yeah.
Dolphin. Get some
nice
stray
enter,
hits with Dolphin, but no real conversion.
So
one
really
more hit
close.
Should do it. I feel so. No, anti-air.
Oh, that was
okay,
one hit, and
that
it
was one
enough.
Hit. But that was just a hit, and he chips it out. That's 1-0 filter.
Yeah. Probably most people were expecting Graham to win
cheered
this.
Cheered on by his Munich co-players.
Well, he's in his home turf. So that's probably giving him the power that he needs. There's some technical difficulties apparently, but I don't know what's going on.
Scores update.
Oh.
Our technician is in. Scores? Hast du nicht die Scores? 1-0 Füße.
Okay.
Oh, so. Hafnir plus.
Oh, they already lost.
Oh, no,
half right a hand.
Hafnir getting him. Up now.
Okay. Go for a Graham
okay,
in control.
They got Seaworld out.
Grammas,
Soul
I mean.
Gets in.
Manages to get his way out of the corner by head edge. Doesn't stay there.
Straight jump H into full conversion.
Grandma's definitely looking strong here.
Hates the bits and takes it.
Okay, this is looking
one
pretty different from the
Grammys.
Last match. He's been in full control this entire round. Except, I mean, I didn't watch the first few seconds, but hey. I'm assuming he was in control there too, because he took 50%.
Summon all his shit, and that's a relaunch combo, and that's a burst bait.
That was not just a base burst bait, that
let's
was also
let's just pretend that drop
burst.
Was intentional. Yeah. Oh, got him.
Hey.
Is this stun? No, it's not stun yet. But he has the meter for YSC.
He did.
Those are looking very strong now.
Oh yeah. I was talking about how the momentum might have shifted, but it shifted right back. That second hit of
okay,
that.
Okay, good overhead blocks. Oh, tries to enter him with 2H and gets a relaunch. Not gets him. 5k just with his.
Didn't quite
Dolphin,
hit the right enter.
Ward. Everything. Oh, counter hit. Solo air hurt box is pretty strange.
But now he's back to zoning game that he hasn't really done since the first round of the first match.
Yeah, now we have the neutral. Hey, conversion into the corner.
Good damage and the corner position.
No meter for YSC.
But he's gonna have it soon.
Okay, 2H. Expect that. Dolphin, cross up. No, 5k.
He didn't hit him on the way down, so that he got hit. That's unfortunate.
Oh, the ball just not had a hitbox there.
Oh, he double jumps to get out of air grab range,
got
but he
down
got
and
hit
his
anyway.
Burst back. Hey,
okay. This might
just mesh it. Watch your go burst. Will he summon a great Galuga? Do the unblockable.
Yeah.
In the background, everyone is rooting for Filter.
All of us rooted.
He
got it.
Will he burst?
He should probably.
I think I smell a gold burst actually.
Oh
my god!
Oh, he didn't get the punish.
Third time he's baited something so well but didn't get the punish.
This
is
too tense. This is so tight! Oh my god!
Wizard does it, knocking out Grammas 2-0. I don't think most people expected that.
That was really strong gameplay from Filser. I'm really happy for him.
Yeah, that was pretty hype. He's pretty surprised himself. Look at his face.
Is this Kidako? Like, no. But it's a close bet. It's a close bet.
Yeah. What?
This is a tech meme.
Okay. Like every time the camera zooms onto you to dance.
Okay, next up.
Now we have.
Who is playing next on screen?
Looks like Shino versus.
They're discussing.
Somebody.
Come on, guys.
guys, make a decision.
Maybe it's not Chino.
Looks like Thompson versus Peter.
Okay. So Thompson, I think, plays Melia, right?
No.
No?
He plays Slayer and Johnny.
Oh. But he played Melia at some point?
No.
No? Oh.
I think he never played Melia, actually. Okay, sound is still getting adjusted.
Or camera positions or whatever.
Camera positions should be okay.
Yeah.
Okay, Peter, the young shining star from Czech Republic, rocking Axel.
Axel, okay, we don't see too many Axels over here. So this is interesting. And yeah, Thompson, you know, pretty much has been at every FFM Rumble, I think, and most German events.
Yeah, there's a stream right there on the other side of the hall, and yeah, they get all the stream revenue.
Oh yeah, it's
maybe
Johnny versus Axel.
Maybe I'm too close to the mic, I don't know.
Oh, that's a chat, that's what we're talking about.
Yeah, we have a chat.
I wasn't looking at all.
Peter. That's actually okay.
Noise gate.
Okay, we are already right in. Scores and player names will be fixed in a minute.
Yeah, we are having some trouble, but that's okay, the matches are in motion. Axel going in. Not zoning. For the overhead. And baits the burst.
Yeah, good anti-air. And he got the corner combos down. Oh. Not quite.
I don't know what that was supposed to be, but I don't think it was that.
He was anticipating he would tech and already attack. Coming
sense.
In swinging. Peter just has to take that little sliver of health. Just chip him out, 2S.
Solid, really solid. Thompson, Thompson not quite sure what he was supposed to do there, I think. But now he's starting the round off.
Can lock pretty hard. Axel doing what he can to really gain the neutral.
Where's the Axel?
Peter. Peeder. Czech Republic.
Yeah. Dropping some points, but to no avail.
No rage switching. This is actually Thompson playing Johnny. Score is 0-0. However, Peter already has a round.
And he's in the lead in this round, too. Thompson looking a little lost. He probably hasn't played this matchup too much.
He fishes for him. And pressure continues. 6H catches the back dash. And oh no, unblockable this time. Comes out in time. Oh, and 10 summer. And Resengeki.
Both characters move with full burst. I don't think we saw one after that first round.
Yeah, bursts were pretty sparingly used.
Yeah.
However,
it's tough
we
because
are already in match two.
Yep.
Peter one up.
Of course, it's kind of tough to burst Axel when he's full
screen. Because Peter already took button check. He became number one.
He won the tournament.
Yeah, he won the tournament. However, King Rasta and ATG did not attend, so.
Oh, yeah.
I think it's pretty even.
Yeah. So you're saying Peter is one of the favorites to win here?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay.
One of the favorites. Alongside with PRK, King Rasta, ATG, Mick.
Of course.
There are a lot of people who can actually take this tournament.
Is anybody else international, let's say, who's here?
Kongster is here.
Kongster. Does he play this?
Kongster plays Exarch. However, he was pretty surprised that we're playing Revelator.
Oh. I thought everywhere in the world was like, anyway, there's a match going on.
Yeah.
And Peter already won their first round again.
Yeah, I think it's self-explanatory what's going on here.
Yeah.
Axel is anti-airing, DPing.
Zoning.
Just taking air, not whiffing DP.
Yep.
Okay. And there
now,
we have
there
it.
We go.
The JoJo meme to be continued.
Yep. But it seems like he got out.
However, Johnny has still a lot of health.
And he's got enough meter to do something happen.
Okay, no more meter.
Well.
And Peter can make the comeback here.
He sure can, especially with all that meter.
Hey.
And
will he drop
more
it this time? Okay, no, he just goes for knockdown.
Ooh,
looking for a mash.
Yep.
There we have the bad angle. Peter with low health, he cannot risk anything. Or at least he cannot get hit.
Yep.
And this should
be it. Oh, that's the burst came right back.
Almost final. Gimmicks
And
Well, he could have area blocked, but
that's a Czech meme.
Okay.
Haitaka stands.
Lots of Czech memes, huh? I'm not really ready for those memes.
Too old, Peter.
Yeah. Pretty good.
Moish.
Pretty damn convincing.
Ich werde jetzt mal meine Dash gehen. I'm gonna play my group matches right now.
Okay, I'm gonna go.
Actually, I'll book the playing on stream in a few minutes, I guess. See you guys then. Okay. Not touching the mic, don't touch the mic.
Now it's just me and you. I'm sorry. So now, is Peter playing again, or is he just having trouble set up? So I don't know who we have up next, but it looks like it's gonna be PRK. With his Zato versus Shino, and I think he plays Meaty. But I was wrong about Thompson, so I'm not gonna say it. I did just say it, but I'm not gonna say it. Setting up still. No, indeed. Grand Blue Hype, yeah. Plenty of waifus in Grand Blue. It's a little weird because we have like 1 second of delay between what they see and what we get on the screen. So a lot of the time we hear them yell and like, yeah, woo, when we haven't quite seen that final hit yet. But it's okay. Not too bad. Oh, yeah. Shino definitely seems to be playing this match, and so is PRK. Share those links, social media, Hard Edge Official, twitch.tv, follow and subscribe and whatever. Also shout out to the sponsors, Neutrons, I can't read that second one, I'm sorry, Harikazen, yeah, Harikazen, Capcom, Numskull, Mad Cats, and Nintendo. Oh yeah, right, he plays Sin. I don't think I'm ever gonna correctly predict Amelia ever again. I'm just gonna keep doing it. So PRK, one of the, you know, favorites to place well at least. And Chino is definitely no slouch. See how this goes. I poke and Dato gets the first hit. And now he has him at range. Gets him to the corner, which is definitely where you'll want to keep him, but he gets back. Okay, he's first to avoid his own corner position. Even so far. Now, since back in the corner, which is where he doesn't want to be, especially against Sato. one of the strongest corner pressure characters with some unblockables and all that nice stuff. Doesn't need it this time. That was our best. Wrong opening by Shino. Oh. Here we go again. This is where the JoJo meets with Vili, sir. Forget about Johnny. No, Johnny obviously also has that really strong run again. Uh-oh. There's a drop combo, I think. Shino doing more running away than, you know, probably wants to, but he has to get away from all of this crap that Zato's throwing towards him. Get some of his own, Oh, started. And that's it. Match won. It wasn't free, but it was pretty convincing anyway. Right back into the next game. No time to think. Strong opening again. He's, he opened the first, the second round of that first match pretty well. Well, but that didn't end up winning him the game. Maybe this time will be different. Definitely has the life lead, and you know he's in a pretty decent position. Many stray hits by both players, not quite getting their game started. And until I say that. And Sato lets him out of the corner. Go ahead, and he... Oh no, he could have closed it out, but he didn't. That's always too bad. Okay. Yeah, he was out of meter, he couldn't have barrier blocked that to save his life. Nice job by Shino. Ooh. What's that that he can't capitalize off of? Lots of people getting into the corner and getting right out. That's not really what's supposed to happen, but uh-oh, there's a stun. It can, oh, that's just the end of the run. Before I could even finish the sentence, he could do enough damage to win that. More throws. Oh, he doesn't bait the gold burst, and for that, PRK gets all the meter. Spends a lot of it to put himself into a good position, land some hits, but lets him ride out again. Not doing the greatest job are both of these players of keeping corner position. We go again. But that's okay, because we're right back in it, and right back out. It is really difficult at that height, of course, to keep someone from dashing out. I'm not hating on anyone, just in case anyone thought that's what I was doing. Anyway, Shino in a difficult spot. Could definitely make that comeback though, but not like that. The arcade takes it. Easy. Gotta drink some water real quick. Okay, now we have Fish, another Sin player. And I forgot his name, I'm sorry. But he plays Kai, as far as I know. At least that's what he played in Casuals. Pretty good. Fish.
Yep. Wer ist links, wer ist rechts?
Also rechts ist Fish und links weiß ich nicht. Fish, probably the premier Sin in Germany. He plays very well in multiple star tournaments over the recent years. Josh is his name, that's right. Thanks, Andy. Let's see how this is. You know, father versus son. Not in real life, but I mean, they totally look like father and son. No, of course, in the game, Sin and Kai are father, son and father. So if you're into some, you know, domestic violence, this is for you. And also, you should probably get some help. But anyway, match is about to start. And right into the pause. Who's getting disqualified here? Obviously, it doesn't count. That was a waste of time. But now this time, maybe you give the Metroid star. Heaven or hell. Duel. One. Let's rock. Alright. That's a pretty sick Sin color. And you know, as a reward for that awesome color, he gets to put his opponent into the corner for some nasty damage. Kai trying to fight his way out. And he is out, but he suffered for it. He's about to take some more damage. This is, of course, Sin's biggest strength, his huge damage output. But now, he's in the corner. He manages to find his way out, gets the stagger on the... what is it? What number is that? Three? Lunches it up. Still has his burst as well. But if he does get into a precarious situation, he can probably get out. Santaya. Eat some of that meat. Keep his meter up. Because he needs that to keep up his game plan. Apply some pressure. Running a little low on that meat meter. Ooh, if he doesn't... Yeah, he should. Okay, he doesn't need that. A little bit of meter. Ooh, close that game up. If he had needed it, he might have actually paid for it, because he would have gone into that starving animation. But of course, he's a pretty skilled and experienced player, so that would have happened. This is the worst. Ooh, and gets the fully charged hit on that. Doesn't get quite the conversion he wanted, I think. This time, he does. But I think that hit him out of the air. It definitely didn't look like he was crouch blocking. Uh-oh. There goes Sin. More damage, please. More! That's about even now. Not anymore. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do in that position? Maybe ride the lightning, I'm not sure how much meter he's in, but that probably wouldn't have worked out. Okay, that's strong blood pressure. As long as he has bars, he can cancel his moves into other moves to keep that up. And as long as he lands hits every once in a while, he'll be able to eat. That's what he wants. Nice block on that. Doesn't let Kai out of the corner until now. But he really only needs one more hit, so whether he's in the corner or not doesn't make too much of a difference. But, oh, that's the end. That was convincing. Fish, I would say, also. Pretty high up there on the list of favorites. And it looks like next we have some more favorites, I think. Maybe not. Yeah, it looks like Rasta is about to play. Think? He's definitely sitting down. I'm not familiar with his opponent. But if he's not good, then he's gonna get the whooping of his life. Because Rasta is very skilled. Usually plays his Faust, but can also play some pretty much anything. Whoopi, okay. Oh, isn't he also Chech? Maybe? I think. Ilya, oh hey, finally. But I didn't guess it, so it doesn't count. Also, you can call me Jesus, but you can also call me Mr. Commentator, if that's what you prefer. Looks like PRK is about to sit down here with me. Give us the rundown on Poppy.
Hello, stream.
Hello. Hello, PRK.
How are you doing, Jesus?
I'm doing okay. How about you?
I'm doing fine as well. Enjoying the tournament? Enjoying what you see?
Yeah, pretty good. Lots of good players have been on the stream as long as I've been commentating it.
So yeah, that's always good. Definitely.
It's also been the scrub. It's like PR or something.
PRK, I think. Yeah, he's a very bad player.
I think you won anyway, right?
I won against Chino and lost against ATG, 1-2.
Yeah.
Pretty close game. So I have one more game that I need to do in my pool. But now we're going to the match. Yep. Poppy, the Swedish player, he's mostly known for Street Fighter, but he has actually been putting a lot of time into Guilty Gear lately.
I have never seen that Melia color before.
They're at console only, actually.
Okay.
New for Revelator. Rasta, one of the best European Fausts,
definitely. And probably one of the best players in Germany as well.
In Austria. German-speaking countries, yes. That is true.
Sorry.
But let's go back to the game. Rasta's getting the hits in mid-screen.
This match is usually in Melia's favor, but it's definitely difficult for her to get in. So until
Faust can make it hard.
Yeah, definitely.
And also, all of Faust's combos can pretty much hurt.
Yeah,
like his damage usually tends to be really high.
Yep. And you can see here, he hasn't landed that many hits, but he's made them count for sure. And there's the air throw.
Yeah, very nice air throw to prevent the escape. First round going to King Rasta. Round style 5K. That's traditional from Faust to do round style 5K.
There's not really much that Minya can do to contest that.
Doesn't sweep work? Like, wouldn't sweep go under 5K? Because, like, 5K doesn't really hit very high,
but I mean,
it's a risky decision, obviously.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Okay, he probably just dropped the disc. The standard Melia, everybody knows it. Knockdown, dash in, 5H. Best mix-up.
Hey man, you gotta do what you gotta do. Anyway, there's some poison, but doesn't get it.
This is
a very bad position for Melia. That's lots of chip.
Yes. Rasta just got very good items in general. He got poison to keep him in the corner. After we got the oil, we just helped his chip damage go really high.
Yeah. Okay, of course, without a view to reverse or anything.
Yep. Okay, first game going to Rasta.
No surprises there. Oh, yeah, collects that donut that makes her the moral victor of this match.
Actually, what you're supposed to do against Faust's donut and chocolates is to actually keep them lying there, because...
Who doesn't want some delicious donuts?
Well, obviously, everybody wants a donut. Yeah.
Anyway.
Like, their effect, to the viewers who do not know, these items actually give you life back, and some meter as well. And the thing is that once they are on the ground, Faust cannot throw anything else. So it's usually the best to just keep it there, so Faust cannot throw anything. Okay, this round, actually in Poppy's favor, both players on burst. Similar life lead, trying to get the air throw. Mini Faust right there, trying to rock Poppy's life. What a beautiful air throw. Hits the Pogo OTG. just one chip to kill.
There's my black hole. One of my least favorite items when I'm facing Faust.
Everyone's least favorite item. Second only to Meteors.
Meteors, oh my god.
That's Dr. Doom on drugs.
Yeah. Oh no, that Goldburst did nothing.
Unfortunately, dropped the combo and got air thrown instead. Scalpel pull into corner carry. And spends the meter. Unfortunately, it's a combo OTG. I'm not sure if Faust has any combo problems on Milia.
I don't.
Okay, just any hit will kill.
But this is Milia. If she gets this one hit into a corner carry and baits the burst, then she could definitely take this.
Rastana has meter and both meter and burst.
Bait burst.
Unfortunately, didn't get out.
He still has a chance.
Gets him. Poison gets him.
That's just...
Unfortunate.
Oh well.
Yeah, but very well played by King Rasta right now. Yeah. Okay, so let's see what our next game is. So you haven't entered the tournament, right?
Nope.
Okay.
I haven't. So I won't be called away for any matches.
Yeah. I still have one match to go.
Well, unless you win, you have more.
Obviously. Oh, it's Speedia, one of my boys.
Yeah, he already played once and he did pretty well.
And he's playing against Leechy, who is relatively new Faust player.
He was in one of the Street Fighter 5 boots that I was organizing, I guess. And he didn't do too well in that.
In Guilty or in Street Fighter?
In Street Fighter 5.
Oh, okay.
So I don't know what he plays.
He's not bad. He's not bad. Definitely not. But in Pidgeot, definitely not a bad player either. Plus, he plays Axel, and nobody knows the Axel matchup. I still have one match to go.
Yeah, we saw his Axel a couple minutes ago. Pretty strong against Thompson, I think. Thompson's Johnny. And Thompson looked pretty lost.
Pretty gratis. That's... I don't want to say it out loud. Now, the thing about Axel is that you just need matchup experience, because the character will otherwise blow you up so hard.
Definitely looks like that. But let's see if Leechy has some experience.
We'll see. I mean, Faust has tons of tools against Axel, no doubt, and Faust can control the space just as well as Axel can. So let's see if the RNG god is on his side.
Well...
Okay, so we're going to the match.
Yep. And he's starting off with that first hit, but then he gets comboed.
He uses
the teleport. I'm so actually surprised he got hit by that.
He was in a bad spot in general because he was like jumping back, and he was kind of in a spot where he couldn't jump out, so he needed to take the guess. Okay, controls the space using 5P.
Excellent.
And he goes into Sparrowhawk.
Oh, no.
Yep. He decided not to be too cheap.
I know.
Like, that's how we can see whether he decides to be cheap, or he continues the Sparrowhawk stance, or he just gets out.
Oh,
Perry!
That was pretty neat.
Yep.
I'm guessing he feels pretty in control, so he doesn't feel the need to go all out with that Sparrowhawk.
Fan's favorite. Oh, wow, he actually drop rants on our YRC. Really the most undroppable YRC input in the game. That actually looked like he tried to parry and then blocked. Oh. Maybe I just saw weird.
It was a little weird. They just kind of stood next to each other for a few seconds. As if they were trying to bait a DP.
Okay, teleport again. Ah, see? Axel's parry is only low or high. So Leechy just right now hit it 2k to beat parry. But there it is again.
Yeah,
Leechy is just too dependent on teleports at the moment.
Yeah, seems to be reacting with that every time, and why it wouldn't.
Exactly. Okay, meters are out. Cross up 6H. I bet that's Faust only. I bet that wouldn't work against any other character. At least I hope it wouldn't work against any other character. Yeah. That's a better word.
But I mean, yeah, Faust deserves it.
Okay. Okay.
Yep.
Your own start drill. Gets counter hit. Yep.
Line and sink. Oh,
no, that was the worst beta burst I've ever seen.
No, it was pretty bad.
It was a pretty bad burst. Especially the stun afterwards was funny. Thing is that counter hit hammer, insane amount of stun.
Yeah.
Okay, he does back dash this time, gets caught by 2K.
Have some items.
Benten-sama.
I get it. Just jumped into his own oil.
Oh.
Okay, PJ just going to the corner.
And, oh no.
Yet another parry.
Oh wait, he did it. I thought it wouldn't, but it did.
It can look like once the once he parries something, he will teleport instantly to you and do anything.
Yeah. And that's not...
It should. Okay. Axel's air combo damage is insane high. Like, his ground combo damage isn't really that high unless he builds wrist gauge. But like, once you jump on him in a bad way, he can 50% combos, easy. People just cheering for Pidgeot with the most fan favorite song.
Ba-ba-da-da. Going for that.
Ba-ba-da-da.
But is that a real song? Is it a song, or is that just something?
If you were Mexican, you would know this song.
Oh damn! I guess I haven't played enough King of Fighters.
Probably. Okay.
Even though they're 13.
2-0 in favor of Pidgeot. The song actually. The reason why it fits fighting games is that. For some reason, the song fits Yori's Infinite in KOF like nothing else. And somehow it also fits Axel's Sparrowhawk stance. Who are the best Guilty Gear players in this tournament? Yes. ATG, the chip player. Fish, the shin player.
Oh,
King Rasta, the Faust player that just played here a while ago. And also Mick is very strong here.
Definitely.
Kongster is playing Guilty Gear. Or at least he should be. I mean, I saw him play casual, so I doubt he's not in the tournament. And he is in a pool.
Ono also said that he was playing, or at least that he was surprised that we're playing Revelator. Yeah. So I'm guessing he'll play. Anyway, Fish again, and Ono.
Fish versus Owner, Shin versus...
Yeah.
But Chumpkin.
Ono was on commentary just a while ago,
yes,
I guess.
Yes, I saw.
Yeah.
What did he tell you?
He told me that you are free.
Nice. I am.
He told me about Kongster, that he is here. And,
I mean, let's see how Fish fares in this matchup. I mean, it's Shin, and Shin is one of the strongest characters in the game. Considered by many to be, like, top three.
Yeah.
And he has so many tools to just keep Potemkin away or deal heavy damage.
Also, Shin is probably the best Shin player we have in the German-speaking
Fish.
Area.
Fish, yeah.
Fish, yeah. What did I just say?
You said Shin.
Huh?
Owner and sister, actually. Yeah. Here comes the fist bump, both players ready. Wait, what?
what are they talking about?
I think he asked him to do a button check and he just went, eh? And he was like, eh, so what? Standard stuff.
Oh,
but I think this is real, this is serious.
Yeah, of course. No friendship allowed.
Fish is best in EU, as in Shin or the best?
And that's a great start for him.
Yep, oof. Such a high damage.
Yeah.
And right in the corner.
Like, look at the damage against Potemkin.
Yep.
Think about how much damage that would have done against
Milia
or Chip.
Chip.
Oh, what the hell? I don't think he's very experienced in that matchup, because otherwise he probably would have capitalized on that.
Yeah, most likely.
Yeah.
But he very nicely punished food with Slide Head. That was really good. Okay, he gets a Trishula. He'll see what the corner mix-up after heat extend is going to be. I think he tried to bait the GP.
Yeah, probably.
Unfortunately, he didn't get the air throw after YSC. But yeah, now he got it. Okay, he can eat. Yeah, that's pretty much the main thing in this matchup for Potemkin. To bait Shin Eaton and punish him with slide head.
But of course, that's easier said than done.
It's easier, but the main problem is that Shin can just use his normals. I mean, his normals are one of the most amazing in the game.
Yeah. Both characters with full burst. I don't think either of them used it last round.
It's actually kind of difficult to burst against Shin properly.
Yeah.
Especially if he just gets pokes. If it's just pokes, then you don't even have like real safe points.
Yeah.
Okay. Gets the food. Let's see what the pressure is. Just the meat.
Oh, nice.
Gets a charge blitz.
Oh, what?
Yep. This will go. This can hurt. I guess he tried. I think he baited the burst afterwards.
Maybe.
Oh. Nope. Oh, not enough range.
Yeah.
Oh, gold burst.
Okay.
That was a good guess for sure.
Why not?
I mean, in this matchup, you need to take anything you can.
Yep.
Okay, one more hit.
Ooh.
I think he could have gotten OTG ICPM, actually.
I thought so too, but I guess not.
Maybe OTG sweep. Who knows? I mean,
Whoa, that was close.
He definitely knows the character better than I do.
Yeah.
Definitely. Okay, second round goes to Ona.
Oh, nice.
Try to get the jump out using 2P.
That risk gauge build up on that flick is disgusting.
Yep.
But so is this damage. Okay.
Oh. Try to charge. Very often it's important to, like, the meta with blitzes and rejecting kind of change in Revelator because charge blitzes don't really blitzes. This is a weird sentence, but it makes sense to people.
Hey man, it's anime.
Like charge blitzes charge blitz only at the start of charge blitz. Amazing.
Ona just did it. Yes. He liked that one.
Well, understandable. I mean, he just won in such a hard matchup.
Yeah. That's the thing with Potemkin. Just one grab, just does so much damage. So even in a hard matchup, you know, if you get that one, it'll make all the difference.
I mean, that's how Potemkin is. And to be honest, that's how all grapplers are.
Pretty much.
Actually, nice air control right there from Leap to stop in midair.
Potemkin already on like 30% life.
He actually could have eaten, which is very good.
Yeah. But he also doesn't have his burst. So it's gonna be really difficult.
But so far, Owner has been getting so much mileage on charge blitz. Fish seems to have like real problems adjusting to charge blitz.
That's true.
Nice.
Yep, convincing roundup for sure.
Yep, and very well confirmed as well.
And he still has his burst as well.
He gets the lead. Gets a knockdown as well. Nice.
Ooh. Oh, he didn't.
Nice bait by Shin.
Absolutely.
By Fish. I mean, Shin's damage from a burst bait very high. Resets the game into neutral.
Oh, wow.
And backdash buster.
So disgusting.
Yes. One of the best backdashes in the game for sure. Oh, wow. And he gets the stun.
Wow, wow, wow. Oh, no. What
was
that?
Oh. No. He gets Hammerfall YRC Buster.
Okay, Gold Burst. Gets a ton of meter, which you can do a lot with.
He pushes into the corner. Gets the flake counter hit. Back into neutral slide head and punish.
No.
Okay, this was so risky.
Wow. Heaven or hell.
Duel. One. Let's rock. Okay, gets a slight head.
Oh,
wow.
DP there.
I wonder how it is for Shin in this matchup and Potemkin when it comes to safe jumps. Because I think a standard Potemkin safe jump doesn't really work on Shin well, because like he can cancel the DP into other specials.
That's kind of the thing about this DP in general.
But you can option select backdash it, so I wonder like how much of a problem it actually is.
Hmm. And okay. While we were saying just a few things, the round already ended.
Yep.
That's sin damage.
Okay, gets over slide hat, punishes.
Into a nasty combo.
Baits the backdash. Doesn't like actually punish it. Okay, this can hurt. This can hurt.
Yep. Oh, he drops it. But gets another hit right away for the burst. Hey.
I don't think it's gonna kill yet. This is gonna carry.
Not quite. Unless.
And he gets a cross up jump in H.
Ooh, yeah. So, yeah. Which was kind of looked like.
Yeah,
he
like,
was ready
like
to play
is this it?
Round.
Is this it?
Yeah.
I didn't want to be washing it. Is this it?
Yeah.
2-1 in favor of Fish. Okay, so what is the next game going to be? I see Kongsa close to the station, but I don't know if that means anything.
It looks like it does. And he has a little bit of a hang-up.
So we are going to have Kongsa versus someone.
Versus.
I'm actually interested in seeing who he is going to play, because he obviously has a Zato, he also has Sol, but he started practicing Johnny.
And it looks like he's fighting Johnny.
And he is fighting Johnny.
Who might also play Johnny.
And Nerf. Johnny's allowed out. Nah, Johnny doesn't play Johnny. He plays Sol.
Yeah, but I think he also plays Johnny at least on the side. So
maybe not.
Okay, so yeah, and Nerf.
And Nerf versus Kongster.
And Nerf, the veteran player in Germany. Sometimes his emotions get the better of him.
Sometimes.
But, you know, definitely not bad. And I've never seen Kongster play Guilty Gear, so I don't know.
He used to play Guilty Gear a lot before. He doesn't play the game actively, but he's still good. Okay, so he's probably going to go with Zato. I actually played EntNetF yesterday with Zato. He enjoyed the character very much and hoped that he can play him some more.
Of course. Who wouldn't?
Who wouldn't?
It's a pleasure. Well, we've already had one international upset, SSJ Sol, so maybe we'll have another one.
Which upset?
But it's a beat... Gramos, yeah.
Oh, it's kind of... yeah, I understand what you're saying. Yep, that's true.
I got a cookie, and I'm gonna use it.
Okay, so this is probably live. At least it seems like it. Yeah, this is it. Okay, Kongs this time with Fuzzy Guard, gets a knockdown. Good burst right there from EntNetF. Anti-air Nobiru. Okay, this is Eddie pressure. Eddie gauges out. This is EntNetF's moment right now to go in. Puts a drill in front of him. Okay, gets the Fafnir.
More Fafnir. More!
Yeah, this is... Like, just look at the wrist gauge. This is just okay, gets upward 2P. Okay, nice blocks right there from EntNetF. Not going into the trap of no mix-up.
However, he's taking a lot of chip and he's not really getting into a position to counter, to apply any pressure himself.
Okay, gets the knockdown from the counter hit 2S.
Ooh, nice.
Doesn't bait a DP. Zato actually has a lot of DP safe setups, especially against Sol.
Yeah.
But they are not mix-ups, so you like need to... You don't really want to do them. Okay, gets Meaty drill into Nobiru. Blocks the dust, doesn't punish the dust properly.
One of those rare times when Sol was actually in range for his dust.
That is true. Oh, very nice sandwich pressure right there from Kongsta.
Really difficult to get rid of that pressure. Looks like PRK will have to play.
Yes, I need to play my last game.
Who are you playing against?
I don't know the player, actually.
Okay, good luck.
Thank you.
So yeah, looks like I won't be eating this cookie. Instead, I'll be commentating this match. Okay. That dive kick. Lands. Gets some damage. This round's definitely looking good for Nerf. Ease him out of the air. definitely. So yeah, I'm being bombarded with cookies, and there now we have Candy.
Hello, what's up, guys? So right now we have Kungster versus Entneft. Kungster, of course, being an old school Guilty Gear guy. Entneft getting the DP, which has two hits, so it can hit both Eddie and Zato. Now in a very... I don't know if this will hit. No,
yeah,
it won't.
Doesn't look like it, but
grab. Just one hit.
Punish for that, but hey, at least you got something.
Very good. Entneft just going for a block.
Oh, God.
Killed Eddie. This is crucial. Dive kick. Oh, he and does. This hits.
I mean, it was pretty safe. It's really hard to enter air that or stay on block as well, so why not?
Yeah, especially if Eddie isn't available. Yeah. You can't use Nobiru for anti-air, so this was a good idea.
Yep.
The counter at hard slash, but couldn't convert off of it. Doesn't anti-air the jumping Zato. Setup, just a sweep. Gets hit in the Fafnir. And now this is very dangerous. Unsummons Eddie, so he gets him into a full bar again. This is it.
Yeah, after that back and forth second round, pretty surprising to see Kungster just dominate that one.
Yeah, I mean, Kungster is, as said, a long-time Guilty Gear player. He used to play Johnny, and I think he will pick Johnny up again in the future. And the round starts! Ground Viper, this German special.
Yeah. Ground Viper, Fafnir, just do it.
And the pressure, a very good burst. I would have burst there as well. Now, back into the corner, this is not good. But Kungster does not... Kungster does not capitalize, and now he is without Eddie again, but Entnef does not capitalize as well on the unavailability of Eddie. Tries to sweep him himself out of the corner.
Yeah. Gets put from round corner right to the next one, doesn't really land a hit himself, but he gets out. So if he's going to do something, he's got to do it now. Didn't happen.
And Nerf has, in order to play this matchup as Soul, you have to capitalize on every single hit, and Nerf is not doing it. He's hitting some hits, like jumping Age and some standing S, but he doesn't get a conversion out of it, and that's kind of bad in this matchup. Doesn't 6P, he could have 6P'd there. He definitely has to anti-air Zato a lot more. There again, but I think actually he was going to try for a grab and did the option select, and that's why the jumping K came out.
Ooh, he doesn't punish the burst.
It's fine. Volcanic Viper again, which is good. Which is a good option when Eddie is not available. So this was good. The drill.
Just kind of zoning him out. He doesn't really need to do much. He's got a big lead.
Yeah. When Eddie is out, he shouldn't press forward. He should keep it at a distance and try to poke away with Gunflame in order to provoke Eddie from getting into the swamp. Or breaking the law, encounter it. But it's a burst, but didn't hit. And this could be it.
Oh, that's kind of a non-mix-up.
Doesn't convert out of the knockdown, and this is it. 2-0.
Yep.
Well played by Kungster.
Pretty convincing. That one round was pretty, competitive.
Yeah, it was.
But besides that, Kungster just ran over him. Stayed solid and took that win.
So now next up, we apparently have Dracula from the Schloss. Mm. Oh, again against Kungster, I see.
Oh, is it? It's going to be interesting. I wonder if Dracula is going to play his chip or his Johnny. He told me that he's playing both, depending on the matchup.
Yeah, yeah.
I wonder which he thinks is better against that.
Against Entneft, he played Johnny. Chip. Dumplings? Okay. I think personally he will go for Johnny because I think when he doesn't know the matchup, he feels more comfortable with someone who is
who has more range.
Yeah, exactly. And who isn't a glass cannon.
Yeah, that's probably important too.
And now Dracula with the shades. There are only two kind of people who wear shades indoors. Blind people and bad people.
I mean,
Okay, so...
He's playing Johnny, so he's kind of got an excuse.
No, Johnny players are not allowed to do that.
I guess Johnny players are bad people.
No, that's true, that's true. Oh, now a wrong start. Hits the coin. Yeah. It's in level 2. Very important.
Aber du spielst Fang.
That's great.
That's okay, that's okay.
Also.
And now, Kungster has Dracula in the corner. Dracula almost got out of the corner, but doesn't capitalize. Good burst. I would have wired Seater as well. Good dash, now back into mid-screen. This is dangerous. Now Eddie Summon gets into the mid-screen setup. Oh, drops the knockdown. That's bad. That's very bad.
One more coin.
Oh, very important.
There we go.
Misses the dash, could have converted there.
Now it gets going.
Counter.
He's just got a landed real hit, so he can start a combo and get into that misfire situation.
Very nice grab from Kungster there. Gets the conversion. Ah, but no, drops it. Commentator's curse.
Well, he had that one chance and he didn't quite get anything out of it.
Yeah, that's true, that's true.
Let's see how this round goes.
But yeah, what's very good is that Dracula is pushing Kungster into the corner, which is important in this matchup.
Yeah, definitely.
And now...
Oh, he puts himself into the corner.
Jumps also back, which is not good. He should have jumped forward.
Uh-oh.
And... Does the unblockable? Damage. Oh, does this hit? I don't know.
Yeah,
it was too far away.
Didn't quite do it.
Very unfortunate. Now... Dracula doesn't capitalize. He should have 6P. Johnny's 6P is so good. But it doesn't work. And now with the Marvel...
More grabs!
Gets the command grab with an unblockable.
And that's it, yeah.
And gets it.
Not much.
I think Dracula tried to blitz shield, but it didn't work out. You still have to guess if... Do a low or the high hits first.
Could he have done his J super? Would that have worked?
That could have worked, but you can also do a safe jump, I think, out of the jump in from Zato. So it doesn't have to work, but it could.
Yeah. So now, Dracula getting pushed to the corner right away again, but nope, not anymore.
Dracula doesn't punish the unsafe summons, which is not good. He should have just crouching punch there.
Yeah, he doesn't really seem to be attacking Eddie too much.
Yeah, the thing is, I don't think he realizes when Kungster goes for the summon and when he doesn't. That's something he has to realize very early on, or else this matchup will be very difficult. Nice knockdown, but mistimes
the
coin.
Oh, he paid out, he doesn't get the punish, that's always sad.
Very difficult with Johnny, I think, because his moves are actually quite slow, even if they look fast. Blocks all the mix-ups, very nice. Doesn't go for the... doesn't bait the grab. Which is very good. Oh, 6P is so good. Oh, nice. Finally punishes the summon.
But then runs right into a drum. Ooh.
Oh, gets the grab and gets the conversion. With the... misses. Probably doesn't know how to hit the combo on a Zato one. Doesn't have really a lot of Zato experience. Blocks the overhead. Very nice. And blocks it again.
So much risk gauge, and there's probably the kill because of that.
Three times the charm, I know. So at this point, the question arises: should have Dracula gone to chip? But I don't think this was a good idea. But it just doesn't pay out for him. Very nice. Gets the counter. Should have capitalized on that one, but didn't. Now back to mid screen, which is where Johnny should have the advantage.
Motion, putting Zato into the corner, but letting right back out.
He doesn't punish the summons. He has so good low moves that punish that have very good priority and gets
there
the punish. Does he?
This should lead to a lot.
And unblockable. Doesn't go for the unblockable.
Oh.
Oh, very nice. Gets the grab with the dust loop again. Unblockable.
Yep, there we go.
This was unsafe.
He could have yellow cancel.
Yeah, but I think he was scared. And I don't know if you can even yellow cancel the mist. I'm not too sure. So don't quote that on me. And Dracula just being on the verge of getting one round. I wanted to grab, but was too far away. And Kungster grabbed it against him.
Now he's in the corner. He still has the life lead, so if he gets out, he is in a good position to win. But
but right now, the life lead doesn't mean a lot, the unblockable. So it's one more combo.
No, he gets out.
One more combo, and this will be the round.
For both players.
Doesn't get the air grab.
Oh.
Hits the low. That was a good idea.
This is so...
One shot.
Come on.
One shot.